never say. I've been on my grind for 7 days. Need a race, swear to God I'll never. Yo guys, what is up and welcome back to another Call of Duty mobile video. So a brand new crate has been added to the game, so obviously we're gonna take a look at it and see how everything does fold out. Hopefully we get a few dope new skins and all of that beautiful stuff. So anyways, before we actually hop into this video, I did start a brand new giveaway on the channel and it is for 3 battle passes. So if you guys do want a free battle pass, then all the steps to enter into the giveaway is going to be on the screen right now. But anyways, with all that out the way, let's hop right into this video. So here we go, time to open up that brand new quartermaster crate, guys, and we have a bunch of epics in this crate. Firstly, we have Carver Butcher from Call of Duty World War II, dope soldier. We also have the AK-117 armor plated, pretty cool. We've got the Cordite, a strafing run, that is such a cool animation. Kind of looks like shooting stars or meteors. Very, very interesting. We've got the same thing for the MW11 over here. We've got an axe with that exact same thing on it as well. Not bad at all. We've got a trip mine. We've got a parachute. Oh, the parachute actually looks dope. We've got the backpack, not bad. And we've got a pretty cool charm called Eagle Eye, not bad at all. We've also got the spray butchered, not bad. We've got Terrence Brooks, a catacomb. And we've got the doing work emote. Wow, this crate is loaded, guys. We've got a sticker. Just look at how much stuff is in this actual crate. Kind of crazy, if you ask me. But I guess here we go. First 10 crates of the day. How is it going to go? Are we gonna get lucky right off the bat? This crate is stacked. And oh, we got the GKS. Not bad start. And we got the charm. 2 epics so far. And no, I thought it was gonna be another epic. I was almost about to be like, yes, but no. Oh, we got the axe strafing run. So that's what, that's 3 epics in 1 10 pool. Not bad at all. Only one of those was guaranteed. The other 2 were not. So not a bad start, guys. So after 2 more 10 pools, we are gonna get another guaranteed epic. Hopefully, we are going to be done after this 10 pull, and then I'm going to be happy. And oh no, that moment I was like, we're going to be done. No, Carbon was like, no, you're not. You're opening up more. So this is going to be the guaranteed one over here. And we got, oh, you got to be kidding me. We got the worst guaranteed one here. Damn, that sucks. That was so bad. No. What do we still need? Okay, at least remaining, there's still a couple of bad ones remaining. So, yeah, 2 more 10 pulls and we are going to get another guaranteed one, but it could be a bad one. So hopefully now we get something. We got 2 more epics. Okay, got 2 more epics. What do we have left? We still got the backpack. That's the only thing that sucks right now. Because if we open up 1 more 10 pull, we are guaranteed 1 more epic. Now the thing, the problem is we have a dope epic over here, we've got another cool epic, we've got a cool epic again, then we got an epic that no one really wants. So it's kind of a risk, but I am gonna load up with exactly enough for 1 more 10 pool, guys, and then we are calling it quits. So hopefully we are gonna get Carver Butcher, or the AK-117, or the Cordite strafing run. But if I'm gonna be honest, I want the Carver Butcher. So we're gonna see what happens. So we are back with just enough card points for 1 more 10 pull. Please, anything but the backpack. Anything but the backpack. Please, no. Let's go. Oh. Oh, yes. Let's go. It wasn't the backpack. Oh, I'm so happy right now. We never got the soldier, though. That's kind of sucks. But we got the Cordite strafing run. Let's go. That wasn't too bad, guys. Okay, so we didn't get the actual epic soldier. We also didn't get the AK-117. We didn't get the backpack. I don't think we got him either, but we did get a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 epics in this pool, and we got quite a few cool ones, even though that is the best one here. What is the odds, by the way, for getting anything here? So Carver Butcher has a 1.84. So everything was like a 1.84. Okay, the backpack has a 4.3. Imagine we got the backpack, I would have been very, very upset. And we didn't get that soldier as well. What was he?
I can find him here. I think I passed him already. Because I really wanted to get him as well, but it seems like we are not going to get him. He had a 1.5. Okay, so it was actually less than the actual epic shoulder. Soldier! Why do I keep on saying shoulder? Soldier, so that's kind of weird. Let's go check out the stuff we just got, guys. We got quite a few cool things. First, go ahead and check out that brand new Cordite. So let's go ahead and go to Gunsmith. That's going to be my first epic Cordite so far. Strafing run. Let's say confirm. So it comes with the OWC foregrip, the MIP extended light barrel, the tactical scope, and the MIP strike stock. Okay, so it actually looks pretty dope, not gonna lie, quite like that. We also got a brand new pistol. Go to secondary. I'm still getting used to the whole new setup. So pistol, we got the MW11 gunsmith, and that's going to be the strafing run. To be honest with you, it doesn't look as wow on the pistol. We got the dive bomb a few days ago, and that's dope. That's a super dope one. The strafing run on the pistol, kind of just there, if I'm going to be honest with you guys. We got a new spray called Butchered. Not bad, even though I don't really care too much about sprays. Just being honest with you guys. And I kind of forgot about this one thing over here. We got a brand new charm, and it's going to be that one, the Eagle. Not bad. One thing I am wondering about the charm rarity is, like, look at this. This is a green one. We've got a blue one. We've got a purple one, and then we got the legendary one. But nothing really is different about any of them. Like, none of them are more wow compared to the other one. Like, for example, that over there isn't much more wow compared to that one over there, if you guys understand what I mean. But overall, it is actually pretty damn dope, the Eagle Eye. Now, we also got another thing that's pretty cool at secondary. That's going to be that new axe skin. I cannot wait to see how that over there is going to look melee. Go to Axe, Gunsmith, and it's going to be the Strafing Run. So, to be honest, it's basically just a normal axe, and they have animated the blade part. Like, you cannot compare this to that. Like, it's completely different in quality, but it's still, it ain't bad. It's actually still pretty cool. So, anyways, with all that out the way, let's hop into a game so I can show you guys exactly how that Cordite Strafing Run does look. So, here it is in-game, and I have two opinions about the gun. The first thing I want to say, I love the animation and I think it looks dope in game. The other thing I want to say about the actual skin that kind of ruins it for me at least is that you can't really actually see that whole flowing animation that great. And that is what makes me think the skin is kind of like an average epic skin. Because at certain times it looks wow, you see that whole beautiful flowing animation. And at other times you barely see anything and then it looks like a stock Cordite. So overall, I would say, firstly, it looks dope, but I would also say on the exact same note, it's kind of meh. So I don't love it, but I don't hate it, and I think it could have actually been better. Like, basically, if they made the Cordite a little bit darker, that flowing animation would have looked a lot better, but still, it ain't bad. Like, when you reload, it's sexy. But when you're just running around, it kind of looks like a no-skin Cordite. So I'm kind of in between of loving it and not liking it that much. But anyways, on a different note, the attachments it comes with is absolutely monster. Like, the gun shreds like nothing. It just kills everything in its way. Super easy to control, barely any recoil, and it just shreds right through anything in its way, which is super fun to use. But then again, you can put those exact same attachments on any single Cordite in the game. So that doesn't mean too much. What you're buying the skin for is the actual skin, not the attachments. But I do want to note, those attachments are quite good in my opinion. A lot of fun to actually go ahead and use. So overall, I also want to kind of talk about the whole crate in general. I like the way they are doing crates this season. So I like that whole thing about duplicate protection, which is great. You can't get the same epic twice. I also like that new system where if you buy 10 crates, you are guaranteed an epic. If you buy 20 or 30 crates, another epic. 50 crates or 40 crates, another epic. I like that a lot. Like, look at my situation, guys. I opened up 50 crates and I got almost every single epic in that crate, which is absolutely amazing, and I love that feature. So overall, the crate experience this season so far has not been too horrible. It's actually the best I think has ever been in this game, which is super good. Now, that's going to be basically everything I have to say. Just to summarize the whole thing about the gun skin, I think it is dope, but I also think it could have been better, which kind of makes it average in my opinion. But anyway, guys, that is going to be all from me. I hope you guys enjoyed this crate opening. And also keep in mind, guys, this season I'm going to be opening up almost every single crate because I really like the way they look so far, and I like the way they work as well. So anyways, I hope all of you enjoyed this video, and I hope all of you guys have a great day. But with that being said, Squally out and cheers. Bye.